Last week, there was a beautiful Women of Distinction event, and it's always so interesting to see these women from across the state contributing for their causes and their communities. Tell us about the woman who you nominated this year.
Well, I was very impressed with all of the different senators and the different that brought their Women of Distinction to Albany, and to see the resumes and the work that these individuals do across the state. Women have always been the backbone in the family and the backbone, as you could see, in this great state from some of the contributions that they've made. And this great woman that I honored is very similar, and that's Dr. Mardie Sheiken, who is a PhD. And she worked with the William O'Connell Midwood Preschool and dealing with the Early Childhood Center for Services for Children and varied diagnoses. So she was very instrumental in the admission process, counseling, and working with these children, and giving a positive school psychologist that was really on top of the game, that knew how to take these kids and get them the best services and to work with their families. But she, being a mother herself, was the head of 222, which is a school in the earlier schools, K-5, and then we had Midwood, 278, which was our middle school, which her kid went to. And she was the president of both those PTAs, and she was a real fighter for the schools in getting in computers and technology and air conditioning, and working to make sure that we addressed the concerns of the school. And I'm a big co-location guy. I believe in charter schools, and there was a charter school they were trying to put in this location. It just wasn't the right fit. And she was one of the leaders that in the community that came out was forced to stop it. And she was a force to be dealt with. She was very, very tough, and she managed to stop that co-location from happening. And she went on. Her daughter today is in Albany, and she was at the event last week. But not only did this mother, a doctor, work with children and with her family and in the community, but we got hit with that Sandy, that terrible, terrible storm. And it's going on 4 years, and there's still hundreds in some communities without housing. I got thousands. Now, I'm not talking about hundreds. In New York City, you take a look at the areas of Queens and Brooklyn, and especially in Garrison Beach, where I am, and other areas like in Sheepshead Bay. We still got 1,000, 1,500, 1,600 people out. Those are big numbers. She went in there. There's a place called the Cork Club on Garrison Avenue, and she worked with the families and tried to give them some counseling, and she worked this all on her own time. And I mean, she's really a great fighter and a great, great lady, and that's why she deserved the recognition that she got here last week. And she's, she's not braggadocious. She's not in the newspapers. She's this quiet little mother from behind the scenes, a doctor that, when she's seen something wrong, whether it be in a PTA at 222 or the PTA at 278, she led the charge to get the changes done. And the same thing over in the Cork Club when we had this terrible, terrible Sandy, at which we still, like I said, have 1,500 people out, thousands that are still out across the districts, which is bad. So I commend her for her service to our communities, to our schools, to our family, to the families and the communities of need. And so we're proud of her. We're very, very proud of her.
It's always also neat to see the women interacting. There's just so much that they can do for one another as well.
Oh, I got to tell you, that's exactly right. There are certain, a husband and wife, they're going to be together for years, and the family and the kids. And when you're out of your home and you're living on one floor, and it's two floors that are just wiped out, and the house is wiped out, and you can't afford to stay and pay rent for another location and keep this house at the same time, a lot of anger gets built up, and misplaced anger.
Yeah.
So she dealt with that misplaced anger and managed to keep our families together when they went through some of the toughest conditions that I've ever witnessed as being a police officer in my earlier years, and a businessman and a community guy and a city councilman before state senator. I never encountered what I've seen here in Sandy, and it's shocking that almost 4 years later we still have this many people that are without housing.
Well, thank God for Dr. Marty Sheiken, your
she
woman
was,
of distinction.
She was really good, and we're thankful for her service.
Yeah.